Okay, we have our model created, and we have made an assembly and inserted our model into the assembly. So the file that we're in right now is not the model file. We are in the assembly file. And what we want to do now is create a blank, because what we want to do is machine this part out. So we're going to show it the starting condition. And the way we're going to do that is to actually make a part file that demonstrates, it shows, illustrates, represents is the word I'm looking for. It will represent the model in its unmachined state. So we're going to start with essentially just a rectangular prism for the blank. Now there are other ways of producing blank geometry to tell the CAM software what the part looks like before it's machined, but this is the most general purpose solution for that. All right, so what we're going to do right now is we're inside that assembly, and we're just going to make a new component in the assembly. This will become the blank. We want to make sure it's a model and that the units match our other part. Let's see, so we'll just call this blank. Of course, you'd probably want to be a little more specific than that, but for our purposes, that's going to be just fine. All right, we don't want to select anything. We just want to create a new empty model. So there's our blank already inserted, but there's no geometry in that file, so let's just pop into that file and we will make some geometry. You can do this any way you want to. I'm just going to make a sketch on here, and our part happens to be, let's see, it's 4 inches by 1.5 inches. All right, and I'm not actually tying this geometry together. I'm just doing this, trying to use as few tools really as possible. So we're just talking about the machining part. So this is kind of a bare bones deal. But our part sketch is fully constrained. We'll extrude it out. And our blank is 1.5 inches tall. There we go. So that's going to represent our blank. Now we're going to pop back out to the assembly. Okay, it'd be nice to be able to see what's going on in there, so we'll go out to our edit object display, and we'll make this part a little bit translucent. There we go. I usually change the color of this to something kind of a blue color. I think that's like cornflower or something. All right, so that just kind of shows what the part looks like before and after. Okay, so we're in this assembly, and we're going to start adding pieces and parts. This part, by the way, is not constrained properly, and I'm going to take a shortcut here and just, where am I? I'm just going to come in here and constrain that with a fixed, and also want that to be fixed. Okay. So I don't want those things sliding around on me. Let's see, did I get that fixed? Let me make sure. That should be fixed as well. Okay, there we go. So now my blank and my the wrench itself are fixed. And like I said, that's maybe not the greatest way to do it, but that's gonna work for our purposes. And now we need to bring in the vise that's gonna hold this part. So let's add that part that is the vise. All right, so we'll download that from the website, get our vise in here, and we will want to mate that into position. Oh, come here, you constrain it into position. Let me first, I don't know, I like to move these around first of all. Oops, nope, not that. Let's just move this so I can see what's going on a little bit better. All right, so it's approximately like that. And now we will constrain it. We'll use this touch constraint. No, not that. Align constraint, sorry. Between those two. And I'm going to touch these two. All right, so that's good enough for now. I'm going to need to have some parallels in here. Let me just slide this down a little bit to where it looks kind of in the rightish sort of range there. And then that's going to tell me, I'm just going to come in here and see sort of what size parallels I might need to get into the range. So it looks like inch and a half parallels might work. All right, so I went out and grabbed some inch and a half parallels and stuck them on the website, so those will be available to you. So I'm going to come in here and add those. So really this, what we're doing here is nothing new. We're just doing an assembly model. So we're just setting up the setting this up the way that it's going to be on the machine. Yeah, let's see. We'll touch this to there, and this to there, and finally we'll want this face to touch the top of the parallels. All right, so there we go. That'll give us some reference about how this part is located in the machine, and that gives us our blank geometry and our part geometry we already had. So that's kind of our general purpose setup.